Before, you'd need an expensive high-end mirrorless or cinema camera to shoot in high-quality 10-bit video. Now with MC Pro 24fps, you can do it too with your Android device. Hey fellow filmmakers and visual storytellers, RJ Bakula here to help empower you to tell better visual stories with the best filmmaking tips, tricks, and techniques. 10-bit video refers to the number of bits used to represent the color information in a video signal. Typically, 8-bit video is the one used in most standard video formats, which captures up to 256 levels per RGB channel. That is, over 16 million colors. This is usually fine for viewing purposes, but when you start playing around with that footage and color grading, it can lead to banding and loss of detail, especially in high contrast scenes like sunsets or sunrises. 10-bit video, on the other hand, provides a wider range of colors and shades, 1024 levels per RGB channel, for a total of more than 1 billion colors. This results in a more detailed and accurate image, and allows for more flexibility when it comes to color grading. First off, you need to know if your smartphone is capable of capturing 10-bit video. If you have the latest flagship phone, no matter what brand it is, you probably have nothing to worry about. But if your Android smartphone is older, released before 2019, then there's a good chance your phone might not be capable. If you're still unsure, here's a list of Android chipsets and devices that support 10-bit shooting. Due to hardware limitations and capabilities, which may vary from device to device, there are a few prerequisite settings needed to enable 10-bit video recording. In the video recording settings, first you need to choose a resolution and frame rate with GPU disabled. Some smartphones have certain resolution or frame rate limitations before 10-bit recording can be enabled. For example, some Sony smartphones will not have access to 10-bit video recording with resolutions higher than Ultra HD or frame rates more than 30 frames per second. Once you have disabled GPU, you will also need to change your codec to HEVC or H.265, which is the proper container for 10-bit video. Now you can change the color depth settings to 10 bits instead of 8 bits. If even after all these settings, the color depth is still inactive, then most likely your device doesn't support 10-bit video at all. Although it is entirely possible to shoot in log color profiles while in 8-bit color depth mode, it is more ideal to do so with 10-bit color depth, since one of the main reasons to shoot in log in the first place is to do color grading, and the extra millions of color can give you that much wiggle space to adjust your footage before it breaks. Technically, you can shoot with 10-bit color in any log configuration, but there are certain gamut and gamma curve combinations that make the most of the 10-bit color depth. When it comes to gamut, or commonly called color space, there are two gamut settings in MC Pro that take advantage of 10-bit color. P3D65 is a gamut originally created by the Digital Cinema Initiatives and Society of Motion Picture and Television Engineer, or SMPTE for short, and is one of the standard color systems in the film industry. Almost all modern HDR video content is created within this color space. Rec 2020 or 2100 is another standard color space and container for 10-bit video. Actually, this gamut contains colors only available to lasers. No monitor, projector, or TV today can display this color space. Even though we can't display the full spectrum of this gamut, the advantage is we have a color space that is wider, clearer, and easier to interpret. As for gamma curves that are suitable for 10-bit video, any of the HDR standard curves, such as HLG and PQ1000, are a good match with these gamuts. This includes HLG 87%, 95%, and 100%, as well as MS-Log 82%, 92%, and 100%. The M-CineLog curve also works well with the P3D65 and Rec 2020 gamuts, although be mindful of possible clipping artifacts. If all this talk of gamut and gamma curves in MC Pro still confuses you, I made a more detailed video about it here. Otherwise, if you found value in this video, please do help support the channel by hitting the like button, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Until next time, reframe your mind.